Now I would like to talk to you about the hedge amongst the A to I about fighting COVID-19 infection. The first hedge stands for hydration. We all know that we need water in the body. 90% of most of the cells are made of water. And when it is depleted, the function of the cells comes down. And if it really depletes much more, then it stops functioning and finally it can even die. So it's very important to keep all our cells hydrated if we want them to be healthy, if we want them to function properly, if we want to fight infections. Infection itself causes a lot of fever. Fever causes dehydration and it weakens the body in more than one way and then brings down the immunity. So you must drink at least 6 to 8 glasses of water or whatever liquids that you want to and keep yourself hydrated very well. The second hedge is all about hygiene. So hygiene is very important because we do not want the virus to sit on us and to infect us. We don't want the virus to come in contact with us. And all this can happen when we follow proper hygiene. We need to keep cleaning every surface before we actually touch it. We need to make sure that there are no viruses on common touching areas. We need to use the proper materials that are required to clean up these places. They say cleanliness is next to godliness. Cleanliness is what helps us today to fight COVID-19. The third point in the hedge is about hand wash. We need to keep washing our hands because most often it is either droplets which fall directly on our face, but more than that, it is the viruses that come in contact with our hands that will eventually enter our body through the eyes, through the nose, through the mouth, through mucous membranes. So we need to make sure that we keep washing our hands all the time, make sure that there are no viruses there. And we need to make sure that the viruses die when we wash our hands or clean our hands. The best way of doing this is using soap and water. And there is a proper way of washing hands to make sure that every part of the hand is totally washed. First, you have to rinse your hands sufficiently well. Then take enough soap from a soap dispenser. And the first surface that you clean is your palms and fingers. Then you clean the interdigital spaces from the back of your hand, one hand after the other. And then the front of the interdigital spaces are rubbed against each other. Then you have to clean the fingers, the front of the fingers by this movement, and the thumb. The thumb is rotated with the other hand and each of these movements should be at least 5 times. Now we clean the nails, the tip of the nails and the nail beds, and finally the wrists are cleaned. So it is done by rotatory movements. And last but not the least is the tap itself. The knob of the tap should be washed so that the contamination in the tap will not come to your hands. So you first wash your hands thoroughly well, take off all the lather that is there. And then once you have washed your hands, you wash the knob of the tap and then close the knob. Using soap has a big advantage because the soap not just takes away the dirt and the viruses and washes it into the basin, but it also helps in destroying the viruses because this particular virus has a lipid layer around it, and this lipid layer is going to get destroyed when it comes in contact with soap water. The other way that we can help cleaning up our hands and destroying the viruses is by using alcohol rub solutions. These solutions should have a minimum of 60% alcohol, and we need to rub it exactly the same way that we wash our hands. We use the same techniques, and then wherever there is no water and soap available, keep using a hand sanitizer which has 60% alcohol and keep rubbing it onto your hands to prevent infection. What is more important is, even if there is something in your hand, it should not get into your body. So try to get out of all the tics that you have developed over time of touching different parts of your face, scratching different parts of your face, or touching your eyes or nose or mouth. And this will help prevent transmitting viruses in case there is something on your hand into your body. The last but not the least of the H's that I want to talk to you is about hope. We always live in hope, and we have to hope for a better future. We have to believe that it's going to happen. We have to believe that we have the capacity to destroy this virus. This may be a small virus with the greatest potential of infecting the whole world population and also trying to destroy each one of us. But then we have immunity in us. We have this mental capacity of having positive thoughts and emotions. And we know this type of emotion builds in a huge immunity in our body, which helps us fight this infection and to eliminate all the viruses in this world. So please keep hoping, hope for a better future, and believe in this. Thank you.